Good control by Marcus Trescothick.
They've strayed onto the leg side, they've been punished. Well, there's confidence for you.
Well, Trescothick is in marvellous form.
Wow, my first proper game of cricket would have been when I was seven. I sort of played junior cricket for my local club, Caincham Cricket Club that was at the time. Playing an under-11s game, just various different friends and people that you knew at the club. But it all went from there very quickly after that. My first experience of playing a higher level or professional level was probably around, I think it was about 15, that I sort of came down here a couple of times and they used to invite you down for a few nets with the pros, which is like, in this day and age, is just totally alien because obviously all the batsmen want to prepare and get ready for the game. My first team debut was a dramatic game against Lancashire. I think I got 3-1, but a short shark game. I remember it being very entertaining and it was all over and it was just like, wow, is this what professional sport's really all about? The innings against Glamorgan was the pivotal moment probably in my international career. Everything came off, everything I tried to do worked. 167 and we ended up winning the game and it was just like, that was the catapult really for me going forward.
Marcus Trescothick, who's making his debut for England.
But the young man has played a tremendous hand.
It was really the big moment, really sort of, I guess, sort of kicking forward to wanting to become an established player. I think any time that you get your hundreds, it gives you that milestone almost, just to try and move on from. I don't think you ever realise you've ever made it at any point because you're always striving for bigger and better things all the time.
And it's 200 to Marcus Trescothick.
I think that was just a stepping stone to what you wanted to try and achieve. You wanted to try and get bigger and better things all the time. And that was just a kickstart to see how it went on. Has my batting evolved? I think it has to. Undoubtedly, if I look back at some of the videos now, my stance is similar-ish, but my movements are far different. People used to always give me a lot of grief about not moving my feet, and I can sort of understand why now. When I look back on videos, I didn't move my feet a great deal, and I think I really sort of developed a bit more foot movements when I came back to county cricket because I had to change the style of play that I wanted to be. Other things evolve as well, playing against spin. Murrelithrum was where it really started for me. Talked about the areas to hit, the angles to try and hit because of the ball spinning so much.
Trescothick's response to a couple of LBW appeals.
Lap sweep, one of his favourite shots against the spinners.
You can't hit in certain positions where you would do against normal spinners, playing on maybe English conditions in that environment, so you have to adjust it completely. But the biggest part of it was obviously giving you the game plan of how to adjust to it. The next part of that, when you're facing Shane Warne, we were doing a lot of defensive work at the time, and there was that great delivery that he bowled against Andrew Strauss, wasn't it, Edge Baston in the 05 Ashes.
Hold him! How about that?
Where it was like it spun massively out of the rough, and the angles that Andrew Strauss created almost allowed that ball to spin in the fashion what he did. And that was then, we all then tried to work at a different area and a different game of what we were trying to do. I have to work really hard on my slip catching because when you're in the county grind, you lose a bit of concentration now and again, but I think you're always trying to find new things to try and invent games to play. The one on the knees was something that we've worked at pretty good. We've sort of played along with that and tried to suddenly thought, whoa, this is a great idea because pitches were, as they would not spin as much or not carry as much as what they used to, the ball never used to get to you. The one round the corner is just, I guess, is just a bit of anticipation. You see it quite often that as soon as somebody goes down to sweep, that the slip will try and run round, and it comes off once in a blue moon, and it just happens this perfect day. Look, if you're good enough to keep playing at the age that you are, if you're still producing the goods, your hunger is still there to do the hard work, the training, the discipline, everything that goes with it, there's no reason why you can't carry on. Whether it's 45, 50, whatever it may be, if you lose either part of those, then of course, it's time to move on and do something different.